All right, so this is one of my very favorite wildflowers. This is called Hoary Puccoon, and the scientific name is Lithospermum canescens. Hoary means basically frosty, and so if you look carefully at the leaves, it's kind of got this whitish tinge, almost like it's been touched by frost, but it hasn't been. And puccoon usually referred to a dye plant. Unfortunately, this particular plant is not, it's not very common like it probably used to be, and that's partly because it doesn't do well under disturbance, and it really can't be propagated as far as we know, at least not by humans. Now, of course, it does pretty good in the wild, and it's done quite well on this little road cut right here. Now, one of the interesting things is a member of the Boraginaceae, so it's got basically what we call the helicoid cyme. So it's curled over right here. The scientific name, Lithospermum, means stone seed. And when you see the seeds from this thing, they're kind of whitish, and they do look like rocks. And they're really, really hard as well, which may contribute to basically why it's not able to be propagated very well by humans. This is also a plant that I learned about in botany way back when. They had the pattern of what's called pin and thrum flowers. So pin flowers will have a really long, pointy stigma and style. And the thrum flowers will actually have a much smaller stigma and style. And even though these plants are bisexual, they're both male and female, they can't pollinate themselves. So a pin has to be pollinated by a thrum, and a thrum has to be pollinated by a pin. So this one right here, you can actually see the stamens there. They're pretty close to the top. So this is probably a thrum from the looks of it. I'll have to look around and see if I can find a pin to compare it to. But most of these are actually not blooming right now. This one happens to be in a really warm and sunny spot, and it's already blooming. So, but it's one of my, it's a really, really neat wildflower. If you see these, protect them. And they don't transplant very well either, so unfortunately it's something that's really hard to get in your garden. And you can't even buy seeds anywhere, because people that buy seeds are like, hey, it doesn't germinate. They have a really, really low germination rate. But like I said, they seem to do great in the wild, and they seem to respond to fire. So if you have some of these, fall burning seems to help them, at least a little bit. What this species has is it has something called heterostyly. So hetero means different, style is the female part. So the styles basically have two forms. Now, there are other plants that apparently can have up to three forms of this, but in this Hoary Puccoon, there's basically just two. So there's what we call the pin and the thrum forms. So the pin has a long style. So the stigma is the end. The style is this long part. So if you see this right here, that's the stigma. This long kind of brownish thing is the style. And this kind of light greenish thing between the sepals here, that's the ovary. So this is the pin form. Now, an individual plant will only produce either pin or the other form, the thrum flowers. So you either get pin flowers or thrum flowers, one or the other. So it's almost like genders, except they're both bisexual. They're both hermaphrodites. They both have male and female parts. However, they function almost like separate sexes, because basically you have the pin can only pollinate the thrum and vice versa. So it's kind of one of the interesting things about this particular plant. So it's probably another one of the reasons why it doesn't persist as long, because essentially it functions as if there were separate male and female, even though there are not. So you have to have a population that has both pin and thrum for them to be able to reproduce. So this one I'm showing you here, this is the pin. So you get the stigma, you get this long kind of brownish style, and this is the ovary down here. So stigma, long style. And where are the stamens? The stamens are actually going to be down here, so they will be low. So the stamens will be lower, the stigma and the style will be up here. So here's basically one of these flowers that I've taken the corolla off, and in most, this is a sympetalous corolla, meaning the petals are fused together. So because they're fused, the stamens will typically be attached to the corolla, and here they are. So notice the stamens, this is where this would be attached, just over where the ovary would be. These stamens are quite low.
So they're not up here at the top. So this is the stamens of the pin form. Now let's look at the thrum form. So the thrum form, you notice that the stamens are pretty close to the opening of the flower. So they're not all the way down at the bottom. You can actually look inside, you can see the stamens. If it's the pin form, a lot of times you cannot see the stamens because they're way down at the bottom. So to look closer, here's the stigma. So here's one of these thrum form plants. I've pulled off the corolla and you can see the stigma. Compared to those others, it's super short. It doesn't even really get much beyond where the sepals are. So you can see you got the sepals. It barely gets beyond the sepals. So to compare, let's go back. This stigma is way beyond the sepals by comparison. So these are very different. These are very different flower morphologies. But it kind of makes sense if you think about it. If a pollinator is going to pick up some pollen from this pin form, it's going to be right around here on these stamens. And guess where the ovary is on the thrum form? It's also down in that same position. So basically they pollinate each other. So hopefully that makes sense with a little bit of this heterostyly that is present in Lithospermum canescens Hoary Puccoon. It's present in the family Boraginaceae and some of the other species, but not all species have it. There are another number of other families that have it, but it's kind of scattered around throughout the plant kingdom. So something new botanically that you can know about. So if you like this kind of content, please like and subscribe, and I'll try to produce more.